Welcome to Civil Technocrats. Today we will see degree of kinematic indeterminacy for beams. Now degree of kinematic indeterminacy, it is also called as degree of freedom. Basically degree of kinematic indeterminacy is related with slope and deflections or deformations. So we know that at any joints there are 3 degrees of freedom. This is also called as degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom means what? At any joint we are having 3 degrees of freedom, that is rotation, displacement in x direction and displacement in y direction. If I draw here the degrees of freedom, here I can say that in x direction, displacement in x direction, displacement in y direction and rotation. Okay, rotation is theta. So here we can say this as a delta x, this is delta y and theta. So at any joint there are 3 degrees of freedom. So these displacement in x direction are called as axial deformations. Okay, then these are our deflections and this is the rotation. This is caused due to the horizontal force or axial force. These are the axial deformations which are caused due to the axial force. These are the vertical deformations which are called by the vertical forces, and the rotation, it is caused by the moment. So we will see what is degrees of freedom. The number of allowed displacements and rotations at a joint is called as degrees of freedom. As I have told you, at a joint there are always 3 degrees of freedom. So now degrees of freedom for beams by considering axial deformations. By considering axial deformations means what? We are going to consider the horizontal deformations or the deformations along the axis of the beam. So now as the formula for the beams are degree of kinematic indeterminacy dk, it is calculated as 3j minus r plus a, where j is the number of joints, r is the number of reactions, a is the additional equation due to internal hinge. We know that, we have seen in last lecture how to calculate the value of a. The a comes into the picture only when the internal hinges are given in the problem. If the internal hinges are not provided, then the value of this a is 0. So a is the additional equation due to internal hinge. A is equal to m dash minus 1, where m dash, we know m dash is the number of members connected to the internal hinge. Now here I will tell you how this formula comes out. Now see, at any joint there are 3 degrees of freedom. Those 3 degrees of freedom are axial deformations which are caused due to axial forces, vertical deformations which are due to the vertical forces, and rotations which are due to the moments. So 1, 2 and 3. So this factor 3 comes from this value: axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation. So 3j at one joint, 3 degrees of freedom are allowed, or these 3 degrees of freedoms are supposed to be there at a single joint. So for j joints the degrees of freedom are 3j, okay, minus the number of reactions. So in the reactions, which type of supports are provided? It is fixed, hinge, simple, roller. Depending upon that we have to see what is the degree of freedom of that joint. And plus a is the additional equation due to the internal hinge. So now I will tell you some degrees of freedoms for the supports. So for the degrees of freedom we will go through this example. Now suppose this is a beam. At this point hinge support is given, and at this point roller support is provided. Okay, now this is the beam. Now to understand this, I will draw this beam like this. This is the beam. Instead of drawing this support at joint, I will show the support over here. Some distance I will keep in between for our understanding purpose, and here the hinge support is provided. Okay, now as I have told you, at joint how many degrees of freedom are allowed? 3 degrees of freedom are allowed. At any joint 3 degrees of freedom are allowed. Which are those 3 degrees of freedom? Axial deformations, then vertical deformations and rotation of the joint, that is due to the moment. Rotation is always due to the moment. Now if I consider a joint here, then axial deformation is allowed. We call this as delta x. Then vertical deformation is allowed, we call this as delta y, and its rotation due to the moment, rotation we call the rotation as theta. Okay, so 1, 2 and 3, 3 degrees of freedoms are there at a single joint. So at this joint now there are 3 degrees of freedom. So I will draw those 3 degrees of freedom. Let us see here, this is horizontal, then vertical, and here rotation due to the moment. Okay, so these 3 degrees of freedom at this joint B, suppose this is joint B, P and A. Now here it is joint A. At A also there are 3 degrees of freedom, horizontal, then vertical and moment. So these are the 3 degrees of freedom at joint A. So these are the degrees of freedom. Now I will draw the support reactions. Now see here, the roller support is provided. So how many reactions are there for the roller support? Roller support is having only one reaction. So I will draw here vertical, one reaction which is there for the roller support. Here it is a hinge support. So how many reactions are there at hinge support? Hinge support carries two reactions. One is vertical, second is horizontal. Okay. Now this support and these degrees of freedom are combined at this point. So these two were combined at this point. So we will get this structure. Now if you think about this point A, now this axial deformation is restrained by this horizontal reaction. So this horizontal axial deformation, that is horizontal deformation, is getting cancelled out due to the horizontal reactions. Similarly, vertical deformation is getting cancelled out due to the vertical reaction at this point. So what is remain now? So here the only movement is remaining. Here the only movement, movement means what? Rotation is remaining. Theta is only there. Theta is only there. So here I can say decay of this joint is 1. Decay of joint A is 1 because the rotation is only present over there at that joint. Now when you see this joint B, now at joint B, if it is free, then there are 3 degrees of freedom: axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation, that is moment. But support at point B is the roller support. Roller support is having only one reaction, that is vertical reaction. So the vertical deformation and vertical reactions are cancelled out. This vertical reaction will not allow this vertical deformation. Okay, so this is cancelled out. Then what is remaining? Axial deformation is remain as it is and moment is also remain as it is. So the decay at the joint B, it is how much? 1 plus 1, it is 2. So 2 degrees of freedom are there, and that is axial deformation and rotation. Okay, so what is the total degree of freedom of this beam? Now if I think the whole structure, then total degree of freedom is, degree of freedom how much it is? 3. Okay, so the total degree of freedom is 3. Now we can solve this by the formula also. How we can solve this by the formula? As I have told you, the formula for this is 3j minus r plus a. The formula for this is the formula 3j minus r plus a. Now we have directly calculated this based on the support reactions. We have calculated the decay degrees of freedom. Now here I will tell you how by using the formula we can calculate this. Now we know the formula, decay is equal to, what is the formula? It is 3j minus r plus a, where j is the number of joints, r is the number of reactions, a is the additional equation due to the internal hinge. Now for that, now here how many joints are there? 1, 2, only 2 joints are there. And how many reactions are there at hinge support? 1, 2 reactions are there. At roller support, 1 reaction is there. So joints are 2 and reactions are 2 plus 1, that is 3. There is no internal hinges provided, so the value of A is 0. So decay is equal to, what is our formula now? Decay is equal to, it is 3 into 2 minus 3 plus 0. So your answer is 3 into 2, 6, 6 minus 3, 3. So the decay of this beam is 3. So by using the formula you are also getting the same answer, and directly also if you do the direct calculation, then also you will get the same answer. So I will tell you how to calculate the decay by directly. Right now just I have calculated. In that way also you can calculate in the exam, and by using this formula also you can calculate that. But my advice is go for by the direct method instead of using the formula. But now in this video lecture, I will tell you both by using the formula as well as by using the directly we can calculate the DKI. So now further, I will tell you the degree of freedom of each joint. What is the degree of freedom of each joint when the different type of support is attached to that joint? Now suppose here a fixed support is attached. Okay, now fixed support is attached. Now what is the degree of freedom? Now suppose if I draw the free body diagram here, so what will be the diagram? I will draw the diagram. This is the beam and here it is the support. Here it is the support. Now how many reactions are there at this joint? This joint is nothing but this joint. For your understanding, I have drawn it like this. So at this joint, if the support is not there, if the support is not there, then how many degrees of freedoms are there at a single joint? 3 degrees of freedom: axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation, that is movement. So I will show here axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation, that is movement. Okay, but now as soon as I for this joint, when I fix this joint with a fixed support, then how many reactions are there at the fixed support? So at fixed support, now this is fixed support, so at fixed support 3 reactions are there: vertical, horizontal and moment. So these 3 reactions are there. Now see here carefully, this horizontal reaction will not allow axial deformation. So horizontal deformation is resisted by this horizontal reaction, so these two will get cancelled. Then this vertical reaction will not allow vertical deformation. Okay, so vertical deformation is get cancelled out with vertical reaction. And here the rotation is getting cancelled out, or this moment which causes the rotation, it's getting cancelled out by this moment which is at the fixed support. So here the degree of freedom or degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 0. So I can say that for fixed support, when the support is fixed, then DK is equal to what? 0. Then the degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 0 for the fixed support. Similarly, now we will see now for hinge support. Now suppose the same beam is there and now hinge support is there. Now second case, hinge support, second type of support is hinge support. Now similarly, I will separate the beam from this joint, beam and support from this joint. So here beam is there and some distance I will keep in between and I will draw this support. Now similar things we are going to apply. As we know that if this joint is a free joint, if the hinge support is not there applied at this joint, then if the joint is free, then how many degrees of freedom are there for a single joint? There are 3 degrees of freedom: axial deformation, vertical and rotation. So I will draw here axial deformation, this is vertical and moment. So this is moment. So 3 degrees of freedom. And now when this support is attached to this point, this is hinge support. So how many reactions are possible at the hinge support? So at hinge support there are 2 reactions. One is vertical and second reaction is horizontal. 2 reactions are possible. Now see who cancel out to whom. Now this axial deformation is horizontal. This is cancel out with this horizontal reaction. This horizontal reaction will not allow axial deformation. Then this vertical reaction also will not allow vertical deformation. Then what is remain? Only the rotation is remaining. Only this moment is remaining. Here this moment is remaining. Rotation is remaining. So here the DK is equal to what? DK is equal to 1. Every other quantity is getting cancelled out. So DK is equal to 1 at this joint. So I can say that for hinge support, when hinge support is there, then the value of DK is equal to what? 1. Now we will see it for roller support. For roller support, now if the roller support is there, okay, what will happen if the roller support is there? Now if the roller support is there, I will again draw the same diagram. This is our joint and I will draw roller support somewhere here. This is the roller support. Now what will actually happen? So how many degrees of freedom are there? There are 3 degrees of freedom at this joint: vertical, then horizontal and then moment. So this is axial deformation, this is vertical deformation, and this is rotation. This is the moment which causes the rotation. So now at roller support, how many reactions are there at roller support? At roller support there is only one vertical reaction. This is the one single reaction at the roller support. So this vertical reaction will not allow vertical deformation. Okay, there is no horizontal reaction, there is no moment, so only there is a vertical reaction. So vertical reaction will stop this vertical deformation. So these two will get cancelled out to each other, vertical deformation and vertical reaction. Now what is remaining? Horizontal deformation is as it is and rotation is as it is, or movement causing the rotation, it is as it is. So how many decay? Decay is equal to 1 plus 1, it is 2. So now whenever we can say that roller support is there, whenever roller support is there, then the value of decay is 2. Whenever the roller support is there, the value of decay is 2. Same is the case for simple support. Simple support is also having only one reaction. Okay, simple support is also having only one reaction. So same is the case as that of roller. Same case is with the simple support also. For simple support also the value of decay is 2. Now for the internal hinge, this is the most important thing. Now for the internal hinge. Now if I draw internal hinge, this is the internal hinge. This is the internal hinge. Now if I draw the diagram of the internal hinge, I will name this internal hinge. Now for the internal hinge, if I draw the separate diagram, then you will get the idea. For the internal hinge here, now this is hinge. Now this is one member, this is another member. At this hinge, movement will be, or the rotation will be there for this member. Okay, I will give the name. This is A, this is point C, this is point B. So here this is our part AC, this is part AC, and here the part CB. So there will be some rotation there at this end. So this is the moment which causes the rotation. Here also there may be some rotation, or there will be definite rotation at this part CB. These two rotations or these two moments are same or may not be same, we don't. Okay, it is depending upon the type of loading. So now two different moments we are getting here. In addition to that, there is a vertical deformation, there is a vertical deformation and horizontal deformation also. Okay, so at hinge the value of decay is, what is the value? 1, 2, 3 and 4. The value of decay is 4. So at internal hinge, the value of degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 4. Now you can analyze the beams by using this direct method also, or by using this formula. Okay, whatever maybe you think it is simple, you can use that. Now we will see some 4-5 problems of the beams, so that you will get familiar with this concept and you can solve the more problem for your practice by yourself. So we will take some numericals now. Now see over here. Now some numericals I am taking. So if you see, this is the first beam which we have taken. Now here, what is our formula? Decay is equal to 3J minus R plus A. This is our formula to calculate the kinematic indeterminacy. So now see the first beam. Now this is the first beam. At this end, hinge support is provided. At the other end, fixed support is provided. And in between there, internal hinge is provided. Okay, internal hinge is provided. Now first of all, we will calculate the degree of kinematic indeterminacy by using the formula. So here, how many joints are there? So here J is equal to number of joints, 1, 2, 3. So total 3 joints are there, 1, 2 and 3. Then R is equal to number of reactions. So now how many reactions are there at this end? So here the hinge support is there. So for the hinge support, 2 reactions are there. One is vertical, second is horizontal. So at this point, 2 reactions are there. How many reactions are there at fixed support? Fixed support carries 3 reactions, vertical, horizontal and moment. So 3 reactions are there at fixed support. total how many reactions are there? 3 plus 2, it is 5. 5 reactions are there. Now here the value of A is not 0. What is the meaning of A? A is the additional equation due to the internal hinge. Now internal hinge is present over there, so we have to calculate what is the value of this A. So how do we calculate the value of A? So A is equal to, what is the formula for A? A is equal to M dash minus 1, where M dash is equal to number of members connected to the internal hinge. Now if you see this internal hinge, there are two members. This is first member and this is second member. Two members are connected to this hinge. So the value of M dash is 2. So it is 2 minus 1, which is equal to 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. So the value of A is 1. Now if you put all these formulas in this equation, then we will get dk is equal to 3 into j, number of joints are 3, minus r, our value of r is 5, plus a, value of a is 1. So the answer will be, now what will be the answer of this? The answer, we will calculate the answer on the calculator. So 3 into 3, it is 9. 3 into 3, 9, minus 5, 4, plus 1, it is 5. So the DKI for this beam is 5. Okay, so the DKI for this beam is 5. Degree of kinematic indeterminacy for this beam is 5. 5 is your answer. Okay, now see, we can calculate it directly also. How to calculate directly? You see here now. So here, which type of support is provided over here? Hinge support is provided. How many reactions are there for hinge support? Now this is a joint. You know that at any joint, how many degrees of freedoms are there? At any joint, 3 degrees of freedoms are there. Axial deformation, vertical deformation and movement at any joint. But at this joint, hinge support is there. So at hinge support, how many reactions are there? One vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction. So axial deformation and vertical deformation are getting cancelled out due to these two reactions. Okay, so if I draw here the diagram, this is axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation. For these reactions, this horizontal will get cancelled out, vertical will get cancelled out. What is remain? One. Only the rotation is remain at this end. Here the internal hinge is there. I have already told you, if the internal hinge is there, what is the value of DKI at that point? So it is 4. How it is 4? Rotation of this member 2, 1 plus 1, 2. Then vertical deformation and horizontal deformation. So the value is 4. And now after that, this is fixed support. So at fixed support, the value of DKI is 0. Because there are 3 reactions at fixed support, which may not allowed axial deformation, vertical deformation and movement. So here it is 4, here the degrees of freedom is 4, and here only one rotation is there. So here it is 1, here it is 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Again you will get the same answer. Now next beam. Consider this problem now. So in this problem here, what is the degrees of freedom of this? So we will calculate by conventional method first. So j is equal to how many joints are there? 1, 2, and 3. 3 joints are there. How many reactions are there? So at fixed support, how many reactions are there at fixed support? 3 reactions are there. How many reactions are there at roller support? It is 1 reaction. At this roller end, also 1 reaction. So total number of reactions, 3 plus 1 plus 1. So total number of reactions are 5. Then value of A here, it is 0, as there is no internal hinges provided over there. So DK is equal to, what is our formula? DK is equal to 3J minus R plus A. This is our formula. So 3J, 3 into 3 minus 5 plus 0. So it will be 3 into 3, 9, 9 minus 5. The answer is 4. So the DKI of this beam is 4. Similarly, now we will calculate by direct method also. So for the direct method, now I have told you how to calculate for direct method here. Now here you can refer this. Okay, here you can refer this one. See here, Which type of support is provided over here? Fixed support. So what is the value of decay at fixed support? It is 0. How it is 0? I have told you already. So the value of decay at this end is 0. Now directly, without using formula, I am telling you how to calculate. Now next support is the roller support. So roller support, see, for roller support, what is the decay? So decay is 2 for the roller support. How it is 2? I have already told you here how it is 2. So it is 2. So I will write here 2 for roller, it is 2, and for another roller here, this is 2. So total decay is 2 plus 2. The answer is 4. So ultimately you will get the same answer if you go by this method or you go by formula. Similarly, now here third problem. Now come to the third problem here. So in this problem, how many joints are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4 joints are there. So J is equal to 4. How many reactions are there? R is equal to, now instead of showing the reactions, I will write the number. So here fixed support is there, so there are 3 reactions. Here the hinge support is there, so 2 reactions. Here again hinge is there, 2 reactions. Here for fixed support, 3 reactions. So total 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 3, 10. No internal hinge is provided over here. So the value of A is 0. Value of A is 0. Now calculate decay. So decay is equal to, what is the answer? Decay is equal to, it is 3J minus R plus A. So it is 3 into 4 minus 10 plus 0, which is equal to 3 into 4, 12, 12 minus 10, it is 2. So the decay of this beam is 2. Now we will directly calculate this decay by referring this here. Okay, so see this. To calculate it directly. Now which type of support is given here? Fixed support. So decay for fixed support, how much is the value? 0. So here degree of static kinematic indeterminacy is 0. Then here hinge support is provided. So at hinge support, see here, this is the hinge support. What is the value of decay at hinge support? The value of decay is 1. So here it is 1. Again, second support is also in support, so here also the value is 1 for hinge. Then last one is fixed support. Again for fixed support the value is 0. So 0. So add these two, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 2. So your final answer will be 2. Okay. So now again, this is the next problem. So in this problem also we will go by formula first. How many joints are there? J is equal to number of joints. So how many joints? 1, 2 and 3. 3 joints are there. R is equal to reactions. How many reactions are there for fixed support? 3 reactions. For hinge support, 2 reactions. For hinge support, 2 reactions. 3 plus 2 plus 2, it is 7. There is no internal hinge, so the value of A is 0. Again, decay is equal to, it is 3 into 3 minus 7 plus 0, so which is equal to 3 into 3, 9, 9 minus 7, 2. So the answer is 2. Degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 2. Now by direct formula, here fixed support is there. Fixed support is having 3 reactions, horizontal, vertical and moment. So decay at this point is 0, so it will not allow horizontal deflection as there is a horizontal reaction. It will not allow vertical deflection as there is a vertical reaction present over here, and it will not allow rotation as there is moment present over here. Okay, so 0. At hinge support there are 2 reactions. First is vertical, second is horizontal. So as vertical reaction is present over here, vertical deformations are not allowed. As horizontal reaction is present over here at this support, horizontal deformations are not allowed. So what is remaining? Only theta, rotation. So rotation is allowed at this point only. So rotation will be there. So here it is the value 1. Same is the formula here also. See, for hinge support, what is the value of decay? Decay is 1. For hinge support 1. So another same way here, for hinge support it is 1. So 1 plus 1, it is 2. So your final answer is 2. Okay. So similarly now for this point. Now for this member. So here first of all we will go by conventional method. So number of joints. J is equal to number of joints. How many joints are there? 1, 2, see here 1. Here it is 2, here it is 3, then here it is 4 and then 5. So total 5 joints are there. How many reactions are there? R is equal to reactions at fixed support, there are three reactions. At hinge support, there are two reactions. At this fixed end, how many reactions are there? Three reactions. Okay. So what are the total external reactions? Sum of the external reactions, 3 plus 3 plus 2. So it is total 8. 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. Now A is equal to, again the formula for A is equal to M dash minus 1. This is the formula for A. What is the value of M dash now? Now this is internal hinge. How many members are connected? 1 and 2. 2 members are connected to the internal hinge. So the value of M dash is 1. So value of M dash is 2 because 2 members are connected. So here 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. The value of A is 1. So now DK is equal to. What is the value of DK? So DK is equal to, it is J is 5. So 3 into 5 minus 8 plus 1. Okay, so DK is equal to, what is the answer? So the answer is, we will calculate it, 3 into 5 minus 8 plus 1. So what is the value of DK? The value of DK is 9 is the value, sorry, 8 is the answer. It is not 9, 8. So the value of DK is 8 over here, degree of kinematic interference. Now we will see by direct method, are we getting the same answer or not. So we will start with this point. This is the fixed support. Okay, now see here, this is the fixed support. So at fixed support, what is the value of DK? The value of DK is 0. And another way how you should remember, at fixed support there are three reactions: horizontal, vertical and moment. So horizontal reaction will not allow horizontal axial deformation, vertical reaction will not allow vertical deformation, and moment will not allow rotation. So therefore the degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 0. At here, this is hinge support. So at hinge support what is DK? DK is 1. So here the DK is 1. Okay, now here this is the internal hinge. So for internal hinge, here for internal hinge, what is the DK? The value of DK is 4. So this is the value of DK is 4. How it comes? Rotation of this member, rotation of this member, then vertical deformation and horizontal deformation, 4. Now apart from this, if you see, this is also joint, but on this joint there is no support. No support is acting on this joint. So this is a free joint. So at any joint, any free joint, how many degrees of freedom are there? I have told you here. At any free joint, 3 degrees of freedom are there: axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation. This is the joint. So at this joint also, axial deformation will be there. Here axial deformation will be there. Vertical deformation is also there and rotation is also there. So the degrees of freedom at this joint is 3. Now if you add these 3, 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 1, 8. So you will get the same answer. You will get the same answer by direct formula also. Now after this, last problem. So in the last problem now, we will calculate the DK. So J is equal to number of joints. So how many joints are there? 1, 2, 3. This is not a joint, it is free end. Okay, so 3 joints are there. This is not a joint, this is free end. Then R is equal to number of reactions. So at fixed support, how many reactions are there? At fixed support, 3 reactions are there at fixed support. At this point here, at a hinge support, how many reactions are there? 2 reactions are there. So 3 plus 2, 5. Total number of reactions, 5. A is equal to 0 as there is no internal hinge. So DK is equal to, what is the formula? Formula is 3J minus R plus A. So it is 3 into J is 3 minus 5 plus 0. So DK is equal to, what is the value? 3 into 3, 9. 9 minus 5, answer is 4. The value of DK is, now we will see what value we will get by direct calculation without using any formula. So now see here, this is fixed support. So fixed support, the value of DK is 0 over here. Now this is hinge support. So as you know, at hinge support the DK is 1. Degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 1. Again take the reference of this. At hinge DK is 1. okay, two reactions are there, so these two reactions will cancel, axial deformation and vertical deformation. So theta remains as it is, moment remains as it is, so decay is 1. So here it is 1. Then this is a joint, this is also a joint, but at this joint there is no support is attached to that joint. So therefore this is a free joint, and at free joint three deformations are there: axial deformation, vertical deformation and rotation moment. So 1, 2 and 3. So here the value is 3. So if you add 3 plus 1, answer is 4. Okay, so in this way you can also directly calculate the decay of any type of beam, and also you can use this formula: decay is equal to 3j minus r plus a for any type of beam. Okay, so now after solving these many examples, I think now you have got the idea, and now you got the concept of this kinematic indeterminacy. So now you can solve the multi-story building problems also by using the same formula and by using the same approach. I hope you enjoy this lecture. Thank you.